Hi, this is TapCat. Welcome back to my fourth season of XCOM 2. Today we're given 8 turns to hack an enemy workstation, and for once the clock isn't really our problem. Our objective is relatively close to the landing point, and I actually have a hacker for this hacking mission. Sounds great! So, just how in the hell did we end up like this? You know, it occurs to me now that we've landed and it's too late to do anything about it that maybe I should have brought 2 specialists instead of 2 grenadiers just to make sure somebody would be in good position to do that hack. But I didn't. Okay, we need to see what we can see. Just move up as far as we can. And you come up right beside her. And let's see. Yeah, I think I just want to get in close. Since we don't even see aliens, I'm not really worried about cover so much. It would just be really nice to make as much forward progress as possible on our first of 8 turns. So we did, and no mishaps. All right. See, I don't really want to stop here. I don't really want to dash. Okay. So if I come up here and there's a group, that would be really bad. So where are we going to go? I could come here. I could like basically bring everybody upstairs. Yeah, I guess I would want him up there for sure. So let's kind of gather. Okay. Somewhat awkward.
Will do.
All right, we're huddled around the pipe here. There's another one. I wonder if I should have sent somebody up that way. I feel like it's a little late for that. I will just move her here. So we won't have any overwatch if somebody walks into us. Okay. So I need to know if somebody's up here. I think the disturbing question is, if they are, yeah, then we'll be revealed to that group and the one up there. Should I not go up? But I mean, imagine if I engage with these guys and then somebody up here ambushes me. I need to go up. I need to know. At least the other group is not close. Oh boy. Okay. That's not great for me, to put it mildly. But, okay. That's not terrible, actually. Where are these guys going to go? They're all leaving. That's so funny. Okay. Yeah. This is the part that's really bad, is having 2 full pods. Are the other guys going to move? No. Wow, I want to be able to shoot at them so badly. So this is what I would call a target-rich environment. There are so many guys. Here's the thing. I feel like we absolutely, positively have to kill this guy this turn. Now, he can take a pretty good shot. So let's see what he does. Okay. I mean, again, it was just a pistol and he doesn't have lightning hands or anything. So you knew it wouldn't be like super potent. But at least he had a good chance to hit. Okay, so her problem is if she goes up there, she's not close enough to really do a lot. So I think what I need to do is bring him here. What's really bad about that is if somebody comes up that stupid pipe. But I need to kill this guy. It's also bad that I'm using a grenade on... Well, I'm not going to use a grenade, but I'm tying up a soldier who could have used a grenade. Let me put it that way. Come on, Jim. Oh, my God. Okay. Yeah. So instead of getting any one of a number of really effective attacks, I have to come up here. I have to kill this guy. That's really frustrating, though. Taking three guys to kill a dude with four health. Okay, so now we had... Oh, I just can't see him from here. Let me move her here. Moving to position. And what I probably need to do is consider my options. I could use a frag grenade, which won't kill anybody, but it'll sure get them started. Or I could use a flashbang. The flashbang would affect three of them. The drone is immune. That's pretty respectable. She's the only other one who's going to get an action. I can move her here. I think I'm going to do this. On your order. I'm going to move her here and try to kill this guy. Okay, good. I'm really glad she didn't miss. That would have been super awkward. Man, you know what? I really hate to pass up on damage, but I think what I need to focus on is minimizing the damage we're going to take this turn. And that means shutting down as many shots as I can. Or at least making them very inaccurate. So hopefully that will help. But I worry about this turn because we killed two out of eight guys. And we disoriented another three. So that leaves three that are fully, you know, healthy and fine. Eva, we need emergency. Yep, okay. That's not a better spot than she had. But she looks like she'll be okay. Well, or not. The drone. Oh no, he's not firing. Okay. Well, this could be trouble because Jim is flanked. All right. Well, that's where disoriented helps a lot. Okay. We're going to have to really try to think this one through. So I need to do my very best to kill as many guys as possible this turn. Now, That guy cannot be flanked. And the sectoid, I would have, okay, this guy, I can't even see him from here. Are you kidding me? Okay. If I come here, I see him, but I don't have him flanked. I have to come down here if I want to do that. And call me crazy, but I'm not really looking to do that. So, I'm thinking the closest thing to a sure thing I've got is if I come here. Can I slash him with... Oh, stop it. 94%, 3 to 5. That's the problem. This is why I freaking hate swords. The damage is so crap. And I know you can take the sword ability. Okay, 4 to 6, that makes a huge difference. That was kind of a nice image. Okay, so we cleared that guy off. And I've kind of blocked the path for anybody who wants to come up, which is nice. Now, if I move her, that guy with Overwatch is going to get busy. I can't do that. I'm going to come here. Yeah. If I went more this way, I figured there was an extremely high chance that at least one guy would take an Overwatch shot at him, and I was just not okay with that. So, what am I thinking? Can you... Yeah, I can't tell. God darn it. None of them can... Okay, I think this'll work. It's hard to tell which tot... Yeah, doggone it. My first instinct was the right one. But even though we got there ugly, the bottom line is I do have some options now. What I wanted to see, and I think I already know the answer. Yeah, I can't hit both of these guys with one grenade. So I'm really tempted to hit this Claude because I feel like he's one of the really important ones to take out because I can't move her. Oh, the stupid drone too. I forgot all... Okay. Let me do this. I don't know. I'm not sure this is really a good play. I got to do something though. So we're going to go ahead and kill this guy. Oh, he can't. Right. He can't see the one that I just went to some trouble to fix it so that he could see. Excellent. Yeah, I could have done that a lot better. So she's the only one left. And what I'm thinking is I'm going to give her aid protocol. And then I'm going to shoot. And hopefully this works. Okay. I still have to worry about the sectoid because he could easily shoot Mary. And he'll have her flanked if he wants to. Mm-hmm. Okay, he's probably going to raise the advent. Yep. Well, okay. I can't complain about that. Wow. This guy. I'm wishing I'd have killed him. Okay. Is she still panicked? Thank God. Yep. I'll be moving. So now I have a new problem, which is I kind of need to kill the sectoid if I can. And I kind of need to kill this jackass, too. So, here's what I'm thinking. I can't get over to that jackass no matter what I do.
I guess I'll be okay.
Let's come. Oh, I forgot. Forgot about the other sectoid. So many guys. I probably should have used my sword there because I only needed 2 damage.
Check it before you get too close. There's something here.
What'd I get? Advanced scope. That's a good one.
It's not explosive or anything, right?
So I really don't want to stay within melee range of this guy. You know what? If I use a grenade, can I make the... Oh, man, he's on Overwatch. Well, if he's on Overwatch, how did he not fire at my Ranger? That is bizarre. I am seriously thinking that I need to do whatever it takes to kill this guy. So let me do this. Because that would drop the zombie, too. Okay. I was thinking that tower would be destructible, and it's not. So that's a little rough. I now just have to hope I get lucky. Wow. Okay. That's very good. Very helpful. So bye-bye, zombie. Now, we still have this guy. Is that it? I think so. The downside... Oh, wait. The drone, of course. So, I don't want to stay where I'm at. But if I move, I'm pretty sure he fires at me. That's awkward. Can I just say that? These are the only 2 soldiers I have left. Okay, well then here's what I'm gonna do. I need to start moving her forward. So I'm gonna do that. I figured that if he fired at her, he wouldn't have a good shot because of the distance, but I admit it was a little risky. So now, what's my chance on Haywire Protocol? Boy, this is really tense. 100%. Well, that's pretty good. I even have a good chance of taking him over, but I can't really take the chance. So here's what I'm thinking. Before I do this, I just want to have my Grenadier shoot, because, well, let's see. If I'm going to shut him down, I don't need to worry about it. But I do want to move her behind full cover. So let me come here. At least related to the sectoid. Okay. I'm going to try and get the drone first. Yeah, I was afraid of that. Okay. So, I mean, Now there's no question whatsoever. What we're going to do is shut him down. I wasn't positive I was going to do that. If she had managed to at least wound it, then I would have considered taking a shot if I had a good enough chance. But of course, yeah, so I could have taken it over. But you know, you never know if you're going to hit it. So I probably would have shut it down either way. Okay. So I'm pretty sure we can kill this guy this turn.
That didn't feel good.
Nope.
I might need some help.
She's on fire. Oh my god. Okay. Okay. Well, this is awesome. And he can't see the stupid sectoid. Let me come here. Okay, we just about got him, but I am going to need some help. Stanislav could throw a grenade, but that's not a guaranteed kill. You know what? I may have made a terrible mistake when I moved him here. He doesn't have a grenade. Oh boy. Oh boy. I mean, I can use aid protocol. And I may have to. Let me come down.
Confirmed.
And I can at least take a pistol shot. I keep forgetting about the stupid drone, too. Wow, this is so bad. Okay, maybe what I need to do, since Jim can't really go where I need him to anyway,
moving to designated position,
like over all the way over there, I'm going to have him come down and use Shredder at point-blank range on this thing. God, I hate their defense. 20% at this phase of the game is so much. So I couldn't even tell. Did we hit it? Yes, it's almost dead. What about you? Can you finish it? You can't hit the stupid sectoid to save your life. All right, so at least that's done. So, I have a slim chance of killing it this way. I probably have a slightly better chance of killing it this way. Hold on. Can I center it on him? It doesn't seem like it. All right, whatever. I knew that would happen. Oh, my other specialist has combat protocol, by the way. So if I had that, I could get this kill. But then I'd be a grenadier short, and that would change all kinds of stuff. I'm going to go for the kill. All right, I didn't get it. But I think that was better than trying for the aid protocol. Okay, so I'm going to have to heal her. We're really taking wounds this time. That is very much not good.
Moving.
I got to try to kill this frickin' jackass, man. Let me do this. Stanislav should be able to do it pretty easily. All right, done. Yeah, but like almost all of us are hurt. That is not good. So I'm just going to come as far as I can with the idea of hacking next turn. I'm going to reload him. Put him on Overwatch. I have no reason whatsoever to believe that that was the last group we're going to fight. So okay, Jim, you go ahead and reload. So I think, except for, no, Stanislav hasn't shot his rifle the whole time. Okay, I'm not even moving. I'm just going to do this because I don't want to reveal a group. That's really all it comes down to. Yeah, that's an easy one. I mean, this would be good, but I only have a 15% chance. Oh, damn it. Okay. That sucks, because getting that early in the game would really help me. Successful acquisition of the advent files. Eliminate any remaining hostiles in the area. Well, what's this about? Let's see if we get anything else. Or a chance at anything good. Yeah, I'm not gonna do that for an extra vision. Okay, so what I'm gonna do with her is I'm just gonna reload. And I did fire his rifle once. Okay. All right, so now everyone is fully loaded. Rolling. And I guess I won't leave her over here either. I'll just come over this way. I think I better heal next turn. Oh, well. We're going to have some things to keep us occupied. That must be a drone. There's an officer. I hit something hard. I think I just killed. Yeah, I killed a trooper. So there's still another trooper type and a captain. And I'm not sure if there's a drone or what. I was really struggling to see what was what. Captain. Trooper. No, you can't really see. All right, fair enough. I'm not going to obsess over it. You still have a grenade, and you can come here for full cover. So let's do that. And yep, I was right. It's a drone. Here's the big question. Can I hit them both? No, I cannot. That really, really sucks. So, what can I do? I get a 67% chance at the officer. I think I'm just going to take my best shot. That was pretty good, as it turned out. And, you know, I think that I can get a flank on him. From elevation, no less. Although, I also am pretty sure I can shoot at the trooper flanking him. And I like that better. Which one is this guy? Oh, he's a straight-up advent officer. Huh. Okay, hold on. Can't quite make it to cover. Let me come here. So I'll have her take this shot and see what happens. Admittedly, my odds aren't great. I'll probably hit him. But that's the problem. It's the killing part. But that's okay. Because, not really. Okay. Let's try to finish the officer. I don't know. Maybe I probably should have saved him till last. At least I got him promoted. That's pretty cool. I fear he's going to do literal nothing for me this turn. I think I'm just going to move him closer. So let's get that done. Now, he's the only one who can still take an action. I got a 55%. Yeah, so I have a better shot with the rifle. All right, well, I would rather get a kill, but the odds are so much worse. Only a 35% chance to hit the stupid soldier. So at least now, both of these guys are severely weakened. And I don't think the drone is going to be able to do anything. Yeah. All right. And I even have Haywire Protocol back up if I need it. So let's see. I think what I want to do for starters, since we have a guy who is on Overwatch and he only has one health, and I don't mind getting my rookie, or not my rookie, but my squatty another kill. There you go. Still no message that she's been promoted for some reason. I have to believe, though, that she will, in fact, be promoted. So now, do I want to use Helen? I think I do. Although that would mean no Haywire Protocol. So I tell you what, I'm not sure he's gotten a kill this whole time. I cannot see it from up here. That's a shame. What's my chance with the sword? 74%. Okay. We're going to try it the old-fashioned way. And I have 94%. And scratch one drone.
I definitely got that one.
You did. Four soldiers wounded out of five. I would not call that stellar. One in particular took four damage. I'm really worried. Up until now, I've mostly been able to keep it to like one soldier wounded per mission. And, you know, so we've done okay with our very limited roster. This could be trouble because I really can't afford to have four of these guys on the shelf for the next month. That would be really bad. So, we'll see. I mean, I don't know what to say, you know. Hopefully, we'll get lucky. And at least a couple of them will come back really quickly. Because I know we had at least one or two guys that only took 1 point of damage. I know the one took bad burn damage. Yep. So poor Mary got hurt really badly. But it's not as bad as it could have been. And she did get promoted. All right, Shredder. And Jim, at least he's coming back really quickly. And I will take suppression. And that's all I get. Wow. Oh, that's not good, man.
Hello, Commander.
On the other hand, we did keep from having to deal with extra reinforcements for every guerrilla ops mission. That's pretty huge. The scientists should also help. All right. Ugh. An engineer. Wow. Okay. Well, we're going to do that for sure. Let me finish. I got 1 day left on this. We'll just get it out of the way. And then we'll go get the engineer. Because I said before, like, we're pretty desperate for that. Okay, we're not going on Operation Regal Beast.
Intense heat, some psionic activity, all signs of a possible conflict. We should move quickly.
Commander, you and I both know what Valen meant to our operation. She was our chief scientist, one of our most valuable assets. With your permission, I'd like to lead this operation personally. I was able to get you out of Advent's clutches. Maybe I can do the same for her. Commander, the aliens continue to make progress on the Avatar project. If we're going to slow them down, we'll need to move fast.
I am sure you will find the results to be as intriguing as I do, Commander.
These magnetic-based weapons are...
Okay. So, good news. We can buy upgraded weapons. Not a second too soon. Now, I get to do something else. Goss weapons are pretty high on my list. I don't need to worry about the faceless autopsy yet because I don't have enough corpses to make a mimic beacon. So, that's not really a thing. The other autopsies won't do me any good because I don't have the proving ground yet. And they unlock, you know, proving ground stuff. So, resistance radio would be a way I could go. I could just get this out of the way. But I think what I'm going to do is I'm just going to keep pushing forward on the weapons.
Valuable applications stemming from this technology. I'll have a report assembled as soon as the...
I want to... Yeah, okay. Actually, crap. I'm going to make contact. I want that engineer, but I need to make sure I do this before the supply drop. And I'm cutting it extremely close if I do it the other order. So... retaliation now. Okay. That's not great for us, for sure. What does that mean? I'm not going to have a ranger. I'll have one grenadier, a sharpshooter, a specialist. I'll probably bring both specialists. Oh, I've got Alessandro too. Okay, so we don't have to bring any straight up rookies, at least. We'll have two grenadiers, two specialists, and a sharpshooter. That's not the worst. Hey, I can field a worse squad than that. But that's going to do it for now. Thanks for watching. I hope we see you next time.